41-41 for pickup or delivery. First, the starting lineup for the visiting Crimson Storm. Leading off and behind the plate, number 8, Colby Entwistle. Batting second and playing second base, number 19, Dax Edmonds. Batting third and in center field, number 34, Jacob Martinez. Batting fourth and in left field, number 28, Trey Orman. Batting fifth and at third base, number 20, Blake Brinkmeyer. Batting sixth and at first base, number 24, Weston Hicks. Batting seventh, the designated hitter, number 22, Chase Hudson. Batting eighth and playing shortstop, number 2, Tucker LeMay. Batting ninth and playing in right field, number 4, Max Diaz. And on the mound for the Crimson Storm in game one, number 21, Tyler Reed. So the Nazarene is coached by Grant Ledbetter. His assistants are Kyle Casey, Kyle Fultz, EJ Taylor, and Tyler Broyles. And now the starters for your Southern Arkansas Muleriders. Leading off and in right field, number 6, Mikey McGinnis. Batting second and behind the plate, number 19, Grant Rosema. Batting third and at shortstop, number 7, Brandon Nickel. Batting fourth and at first base, number 4, Will Richardson. Batting fifth and in center field, number 3, Chris Lyles. Batting sixth and in left field, number 11, Trace Shoup. Batting seventh, the designated hitter, number 35, Carter Clairhout. Batting eighth and at third base, number 21, Jaden Woolbright. Batting ninth and playing second base, number 13, Chris Sutton. And on the mound for the Muleriders in game one, number 23, Jeremy Adorno. Muleriders are coached by Justin Pettigrew. His assistants are Adam Anderson, Jacob Caples, Connor Baxter, and Eric Toller. This evening's starting lineups have been brought to you by Domino's Pizza. Domino's Pizza, the official pizza provider of the Muleriders. Ladies and gentlemen, at this time, we ask that you please stand. Gentlemen, remove all headgears. We honor America with the playing of the national anthem.
Agent Gary Donfera.
Knock your taste buds out of the park with the Corner Clubhouse, 100 South Washington on the Magnolia Square. We're talking mouth-watering steaks cut in-house, burgers, loaded nachos, salads, wraps, quesadillas, and more. Choose from an array of legendary baked potatoes like the Chicken Fajita and Chicken Bacon Ranch. Menu updates, picks, and more. Search the Corner Clubhouse on Facebook. Daily specials, a full bar, big screens for the big games, and only a short stop away. It's the Corner Clubhouse. Satisfy your cravings with a grand slam today.
Fun at the old ballpark. Got Muleriders this afternoon taking on the Crimson Storm of Southern Nazarene University. Dan Gregory along with Ryan Phillips. As we wrap up our Farmers Bank and Trust pregame show, reminds you that school spirit runs deep at Farmers Bank and Trust. Try their new Snapchat filters for SAU, Magnolia High School, and other area schools. Just visit myfarmers.bank, click Snap Your Team. Farmers Bank and Trust, equal housing lender. Member FDIC, Jeremy Adorno on the mound for the Muleriders this afternoon. He's just finished warming up. Jeremy comes in with the really un-Jeremy numbers so far on the season. Ryan, he's 2-2 with a 4.64 ERA. He has started six games for SAU, pitched 33 innings, given up 26 hits, 18 runs, 17 earned. He's walked 23 and struck out 39. 217 batting average against Jeremy Adorno. He is ready to go.
Well, part of it is he set the bar so unbelievably high in his first couple of seasons.
First pitch to Colby Entwistle on the way, and it's foul back and out of play. Entwistle, he's the catcher, batting leadoff for Southern Nazarene. Entwistle hitting 253. One home run, eight driven in. That pitch is a strike. So quickly, Adorno ahead on the count. No balls, two strikes. Well, probably the difference that I see in Adorno is the number of walks. There's strike three called. Caught the inside corner. I think that was supposed to be like a slider. It didn't break, but it stayed on the inner corner, and it's strike three called on Colby Entwistle.
Yeah, you're exactly right. And really, Jeremy's just struggled with his control, specifically early in the games. Now, if he is in the strike zone early, that is going to be a good sign for SAU.
Dax Edmonds at the plate. He took a strike. Good fastball. Yeah. He had Dax Edmonds a little confused there. A 324 hitter, one homer and 14 runs batted in. The pitch from Adorno on the way. It's up, a fastball. After Edmonds, it'll be the center fielder, Jacob Martinez. Then the left fielder, Trey Orman. That's cleanup. The third baseman, Blake Brinkmeyer, hits third. Here's the pitch, and it's fouled off to the right side, out of play. First baseman, Weston Hicks, hits in the sixth hole. Then the DH, Chase Hudson, shortstop, Tucker LeMay, and the right fielder, Max Dias.
Yeah, Adorno early on foul in the low 90s.
Here's the 1-2 pitch. Off speed, stay just a little bit up. And the count goes to 2 balls, 2 strikes. Well, glad to finally be on the air with some baseball this weekend from SAU. The infield looks good. Got turf infield. It's the outfield. Yeah. It could be an issue. There's one foul back over the backstop and out of play. The wind, got a pretty good wind blowing straight in from center field right now. And we need some good drying out wind out there in some spots in the outfield.
Yeah, coming in from the north, and it's going to usher in the cooler weather.
Adorno's pitch, fastball, strike three called on the outside corner, about knee high, and 2 ring-ups to start things off here tonight at SAU.
Adorno certainly looked sharp early on this evening, and that fastball popped in at 93. 2 Southern Nazarene hitters and 2 punch-outs.
Well, here's the leading hitter on this Crimson Storm team, Jacob Martinez, batting .378, a homer and 12 driven in. He bats from the left side. The pitch from Adorno on the way, off-speed pitch. That's the beauty, strike one. Yeah, he's throwing strikes so far.
Yeah, fastballs in the zone, his off-speed stuff, sliders, curve, everything is looking spot on.
A 1 delivery, fastball, swing and a miss. Strike 2 on Martinez. Would he strike out the side for top of the first inning? He might. He's close. Here's the 0-2. Swing and a miss. Down on strikes goes Martinez. K. A couple of backward ones in there. 1-2-3 go the Crimson Storm in the top of the first inning. This is Mule Rider Baseball.
This week's At Your Service featured item is Odoban deodorizer and disinfectant. Odoban eliminates odors caused by pets, mildew, urine, smoke, and sewage. Odoban kills 99.9% of germs in 60 seconds and is effective on hard and soft surfaces. Get your hands on a bottle of Odoban today. Shop online by visiting atyourservicestore.com or go by 1506 North Vine in Magnolia. At Your Service Environmental Solutions, where they know the power of clean.
In Magnolia, you might see me at a local game, or we might cross paths at the grocery store or the next benefit. I'm your local Farm Bureau agent, your local expert when it comes to protecting what you love and depend on. I'm Mark Trout. Call me at 234-1966 for a quick auto, home, or life insurance quote and to learn more about how Farm Bureau Insurance can save you time and money. That's Mark Trout at 234-1966.
Magnolia Travel Center is the only homegrown fuel stop in Magnolia and offers premium non-ethanol gas, great for ATVs, boats, lawnmowers, and other small engines. They also offer off-road diesel. These fueling options are offered at your convenience, night or day, 7 days a week, and are located on the last 2 fueling bays in the back of the store. Endless breakfast options, daily lunch specials, the Flavor Shot Fountain Center, salads, pizzas, and more. Lower prices with a local feel. It's Magnolia Travel Center. Full menus available on MagnoliaTravelCenter.com.
Tyler Reed, big right-hander for Southern Nazarene out on the mound, finishing his warm-up tosses. He is a freshman out of Pampa, Texas. Don't have his height, but he's tall and slender. It looks like he's a right-hander. This is his first start of the year. Reed's numbers, he has no wins or losses. It's only his 4th appearance of the year, and like I said, first start. A 13.50 ERA. He's only pitched 2/3 of an inning, though, giving up 2 hits and 1 run. It was earned. He's walked 3 and no strikeouts. First man he faces, Mikey McGinnis, and that hit him. That was chin music up under his chin, and apparently it must have nicked him a little bit there. He doesn't appear to be hurt. That was right up under the chin, wasn't it?
Yeah, it was. And McGinnis, kind of a flip-flop. We've seen him move to the one hole. Chris Sutton in the nine spot. McGinnis does exactly what you want to do. Get aboard.
So that'll bring Grant Roseman to the plate for the Muleriders. Muleriders catcher. That's from a left side. Pitch swung on. High fly ball. That's it. Pretty well. Well, too high in the air out to left field. The left fielder, Orman, kind of circled the wagons out there, and he makes the catch in left. So Rosema's first pitch swinging flies to left field. There's one out. McGinnis stays over there at first base, and that brings Brandon Nickel to the plate.
Yeah, with this wind, if you're going to hit one out tonight, you are going to have to get every ounce of it. And Rosema just a little bit underneath that one, skied it, and the wind definitely kept it in the park.
Nickel at the plate for SAU. Throw to first base. Almost threw it away. Back in there safely is McGinnis.
You were talking about Reed, the pitcher, his height. Interestingly enough, their roster online has
does it
everyone okay. else's height and weight except his.
Okay.
So
pitch to Nickel. Misses outside for a ball. Yeah, one ball, no strikes. Nickel hitting 383.
Yeah, Nickel's been on a home run tear as of late as well. What's he got, eight on the season?
He's... yeah, 8 and 27 driven in. And the pitch, fastball, he bounced it up there, and it bounces to the backstop. And McGinnis down to second base on the wild pitch. So Reed, on his first start of the year, really has not pitched even a full inning as of yet, but he's out there.
They've already got action in the bullpen.
Well, he's definitely wild. Ooh. Sure nervous, and that one's up above the head. Brandon Nickel. Nickel, the Muleriders shortstop, hits third in the order. Will Richardson, the cleanup hitter, the first baseman, is next. And the pitch to Nickel. Fastball right down central for a strike, taking that one all the way on 3-0.
Yeah, Reed, upper 80s with his fastball.
Check of the runner back at second. One on one out. Here's the pitch. Fastball, that's hit high in the air out toward right center field. Martinez is under it. He makes the catch, a tag at second, and McGinnis advances over to third base. So there are two out here in the bottom half of the first inning for SAU.
See if Richardson can come up with a clutch two-out hit to give SAU an early lead.
Well, as wild as this young man Reed has been, Muleriders are up there. When they get one to hit, they've been swinging, and we've had a couple of fly ball outs. And Will Richardson steps in. Leads the team at 402, six homers, 32 driven in. First pitch misses for ball one. Chris Lyles moves on deck, the center fielder. We got a little bit of sunshine out there, don't we?
Yeah. It's been peeking out throughout the afternoon.
Here's the pitch from Reed, fouled off to the right side, out of play. One ball, one strike is the count. Reed from the stretch to the plate. That's it. Hard pass to diving second baseman out into right center field. Richardson drives in McGinnis from third base, an RBI single.
Yeah, you know Coach Pettigrew loves seeing that, a clutch two-out hit, and that's really where Henderson State excelled last weekend. And SAU struggled a little bit, but good job there as Richardson's going to move his average even farther north to 400, and again, a good two-out RBI single.
And now Chris Lyles to the plate. He's the Muleriders center fielder, batting 301. Two dingers, 17 ribbies. First pitch misses for ball one. Tyler Reed, tall right-hander for the Southern Nazarene Crimson Storm. Here's the pitch, a fastball, and he fouled that one back and up off the, ooh, look out, right into the crowd right down below us. Hopefully nobody got hit by that one.
It skipped off the piping of the backstop. And
yeah, it bounced and then went up to the top off the top of the backstop and then kind of came back left. Right in the middle of the crowd, right behind home plate, there's a called strike to Chris Lyles.
You can tell with Lyles' reaction, he thought that was a little bit inside.
It's a ball and two strikes. From the stretch, the pitch, And that's fouled off to the right side and out of play.
Good velocity. That one touched 90 on the radar.
Reed has his sign. Now comes in. And he chased one out of the strike zone, but it goes to the backstop. And Lyle's down to first. The throw there is wild. And he's going to be on safely at first base. So a strikeout, a wild pitch, and then the throw from the catcher wasn't particularly good down in the outfield or in foul territory. And Lyle's hustled that one out.
Well, now Richardson in scoring position on second base.
Fastball misses outside to Trace Shoup. Shoup batting 351. Three home runs, 20 runs batted in. Pitch comes foul, tip is a strike. Carter Clairhout is on deck for SAU. Bats seventh in the order. Jaden Woolbright's the eight-hole hitter. Third baseman and the second baseman, Chris Sutton, hitting ninth. 1-1 delivery. And a check swing. Slow roller right side. Second baseman Edmonds charges. And he throws him out at first base. And that will retire SAU. Oh, the Mule Riders in the bottom of the first inning come up with one run on one base hit. There were no errors. And two men. Left on base. After 1-0 SAU, this is Mule Rider Baseball.
Hey everyone, it's Andy Sharp, Market President at Bodcaw Bank. We wanted to share a few words with you that embody who we are. Here at Bodcaw Bank, we believe in
relationships,
access,
collaboration,
partnership,
authenticity.
Why? Because we desire a superior banking experience for our patrons. Whether you're purchasing a home, opening your grandkids' first savings account, or looking to partner in a business venture, Bodcaw Bank is the community bank you deserve and the premier banking experience you can expect. For what's ahead, member FDIC, Equal Housing Lender.
Spring into another season of life with Chambliss & Davis Family Practice in Magnolia. Chambliss & Davis accept patients of all ages, from newborn to elderly, with most insurances accepted, including United Healthcare. They do primary care, weight loss management, DOT physicals, cool sculpting, bio-T hormone physicals, and more. They're open Monday through Thursdays from 8 till 4 and Fridays 8 till noon. Your patient applications are being accepted. Be ready for whatever life brings you with Chambliss & Davis Family Practice, where your primary care is their primary concern.
But
yeah,
they went with the wild pitch, which it was.
Yeah.
Probably going to the top of the second inning. SAU gets the early 1-0 lead on the Crimson Storm. They'll start off with their left fielder, Trey Orman. He's their cleanup hitter, batting 349. Six home runs, 23 runs batted in. There's one hit hard on the nose, a line drive out into left field, down for a base hit. So Orman is aboard to lead off the second inning for the Crimson Storm of Southern Nazarene.
Yeah, you can see how soft that outfield is. That ball, it's kind of hit off the end of the bat, but a line shot, and once it hit the outfield grass, it came to almost a stop.
Now Blake Brinkmeyer batting 348. He's driven in 12, does not have a home run. Bats from the left side. He's their third baseman. Leadoff man Orman on at first. Gets a good lead. Here's the pitch. Fastball missed outside from Jeremy Adorno. It's going to be a little spongy out there, I'm sure. Hope nobody gets hurt. Good lead at first. Here's the pitch. Fastball, that's outside as well. Two balls, no strikes to Brinkmeyer. After him, Weston Hicks, their first baseman, due up. He's got five home runs on the season. 2-0 delivery, fastball, that just caught the outside corner. 2-1. Kids having to dodge the mud puddles, too, out there playing ball in foul ground. Of course, they don't typically like to do that.
No, they don't like dodging.
Throw to first base, runners back.
Yeah, still pretty good crowd, especially given the different time adjustments and scheduling.
2-1 count from the stretch. Adorno to Brinkmeyer. Brinkmeyer on the nose right up the middle, but Lyles does not have to move. Line drive carries right to Lyles in center field for out number one.
You're not kidding. I don't think Lyles took a step.
No, he didn't.
It was literally right to him, caught it in his shoulders. So.
Kind of looked like he wanted to move.
Yeah,
but he said, coming right at me.
Right at me. He was
waiting to see whether it sunk or went up. Sometimes that line drive straight edge is
tough to read.
One of the toughest things to read. Weston Hicks at the plate. The pitch to the backstop, and the runner will advance to second base. And I mean, that one was way outside. It bounced in the other batter's box, and it wasn't right on the edge of the other batter's box. It was out there pretty good.
Yeah, that looked like that just slipped out of the hand of Adorno. I don't know if the ball may have been wet hitting the turf, but Rose
the problem
had no
is
shot.
We bragged on his control too
that was
much
it.
In the first inning.
Well, when you come out and strike out the first three, it's a certainly brag worthy, I think.
Ball and no strikes to Weston Hicks. Adorno's pitch. There's a strike on the outer corner. Hicks batting .286. Like I said, he's got five home runs, 18 driven in. And the pitch popped back and out of play. It's 1-2 on Hicks. Chase Hudson, their DH on deck. Starting at noon tomorrow. They got two more to play, and then some of the Nazarenes got a long drive back home. A one ball, two strike count. The pitch on the way from Adorno. Fastball, a little up and away. Evens the count, two balls, two strikes.
We get to make that return trip next week. Not quite all the way into Bethany where Southern Nazarene is, but in the Oklahoma City vicinity.
Is Shawnee just this side? About 30 minutes closer than OKC. There's a strike called outside corner. Down on strikes, Weston Hicks. He has rung up.
That's strikeout number four. Three of those looking. So Adorno's dialed in.
Chase Hudson steps to the plate. Their designated hitter. He is a southpaw as well. Bats from the left side. Hudson hitting .339. A homer and 15 runs batted in. Adorno checks second. Now throws back there. The runner dives back in safely.
That shouldn't have been close, but Sutton's tag was so, you talk about just lightning fast out there. Your Rider second baseman got it down in a hurry and made it fairly interesting at second base.
Waiting for the first pitch to Chase Hudson. Here it comes from Adorno, and he missed outside for a ball. One ball, no strikes. Your Riders in the Crimson Storm. Well, Southern Nazarene, by this series being pushed back so much, they're going to have to miss their women's basketball team playing for the regional championship tomorrow. There's a pitch up for a strike. They're hosting that women's regional basketball tournament. And they're playing Minnesota State Mankato in the regional finals tomorrow. 2-0 delivery. Fastball at the knees. 2-1. They beat Minnesota State, a winner over Harding yesterday. Very close game. 2-1 delivery, fouled off to the left side, and that is out of play. I don't trust my memory, so.
You're going to double check?
I'm gonna bring the bracket up. Arkansas Tech's guys fell in the they had to go to Minnesota State Mankato and fell in their first game. There's a line out into left center field. That's in the gap. It's going to get down. Cut off by Lyles. Runner will score easily from second, though. Here comes the throw into second. And Hudson sliding in with an RBI double. He just went with the pitch, the left-handed hitter, and hit it into the gap out in left center field.
Yeah, short of the warning track, but in the direction of the 375 sign and left center. Lyles was all out, just couldn't quite catch up with it. The ball kept tailing away a little bit from him at center.
Tucker LeMay now to the plate, batting 172. He's a right-handed hitter. Right, actually, first the pitch missed outside. It was Southern Nazarene that beat Harding in the semifinals in the women's. SNU 68-65 over Harding yesterday, and they're playing the SNU plays Minnesota State, who beat Fort Hays State yesterday. Swing and a miss at an off-speed pitch. LeMay way out in front. That's a 7 o'clock. Will they make it? No, they won't.
They're not.
No, they won't. They'd have to leave at noon when we start playing.
They would need a jet to get there.
Yeah. One ball, one strike to LeMay. Adorno's pitch. Slider hard.
A little bit low.
Yeah, a little low and inside. And in the men's regional up at Minnesota State, they defeated Arkansas Tech 75-68 in the first round. Pitch up and in to Tucker LeMay. They are playing in about an hour. Playing Minnesota State Moorhead. 3-1 pitch, fastball, strike two.
All right, what Minnesota State, the school on coach?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
And it was fictional at that point, wasn't it?
Well, yeah, there are some Minnesota States, but they're like Minnesota State Mankato, Minnesota State, yeah. Here's the 3-2, hard hit, but on the ground, couple of hops to the shortstop, Nickel, and Nickel throws out LeMay, and that retires the side. In the inning for Southern Nazarene, one run on two base hits, no errors, one man left on base. We go to the bottom of the second. We're tied at one. This is Muleriders Baseball.
If you're like most Americans, you spend over 8 hours a week in your car. So naturally, you want to be satisfied with its performance. That's why you need to know about Spittler Tire and Auto. Folks around here have been trusting Spittler Tire and Auto for over 17 years. They have 10 service bays to handle all kinds of repairs, tune-ups, brakes, mufflers, oil changes, tires, and more. Whatever your car or truck needs, trust the experts at Spittler Tire and Auto in the Dairy Queen Shopping Center, 521 East Main in Magnolia.
A little bit later on, we'll have our mid-game summary service, Magnolia Regional Medical Center. The American Cancer Society recommends that women receive annual mammograms beginning at age 40. At Magnolia Regional Medical Center, they offer state-of-the-art digital mammography in a comfortable and friendly environment. Call to schedule your appointment at 235-3516, 235-3516. Also, every game, we spotlight a Mule Rider. Join us later for our Bud Call Bank Mule Rider Spotlight. Bud Call Bank, local bank, local people. Enjoy the benefits of hometown banking at Bud Call Bank, serving us in South Arkansas since 1903. Three locations to serve us on North Jackson and Magnolia, 2125 North Jackson, 307 Thomas Street in Stamps, and 3625 Richmond Road in Texarkana. Tyler Reed back to the mound for the Crimson Storm of... Actually, that's a new pitcher. Hey, got a new pitcher out there. Okay, they sure do. That is Lincoln Klein.
Yeah, he was the guy that was out there warming up, and I just noticed it too. He's another tall hander. But, yeah, he was warming up back in the first inning.
So just one inning for Tyler Reed. Gives up one run, one hit. You know, he was wild, but he did hit a batter, the initial batter, but that was it. He didn't walk any.
It was also his first start of the season,
yeah.
So who knows how long he would have been willing to ride that hot hand if he was on.
First pitch misses low and inside. Claire Hout, the leadoff hitter, bottom three in the order due up here for SAU in the bottom of the second inning. Claire Hout hitting 302. Two homers, 21 driven in. Here's the pitch. And he took it inside, ball two. Two balls and no strikes.
Yeah, Reed came into today's action with only three appearances and two-thirds of an inning worked. So, yeah, would not expect him to have gone very long.
Pitch is low. 3 balls, no strikes. As the saying goes, let's make hay while the sun shines. Play baseball while the sun shines. And on into the night. There's a strike on the inside corner to Carter Clairhout. Again, we start at noon tomorrow, doubleheader tomorrow. It'll be a little cooler tomorrow. 3-1 pitch, low ball four. Leadoff walk for Clairhout. Well, Mule Riders with the leadoff man on here in the bottom of the second. And I bring Jaden Woolbright, Mule Rider third baseman, to the plate. Woolbright batting 239. 3 home runs and 16 runs batted in.
Yeah, Woolbright also got a little work on the mound during the midweek game.
Pitch misses outside for ball one.
Boy, Clairhout got a huge secondary lead as that ball was way outside, and he wasn't sure the catcher, Entwistle, was going to be able to corral it.
Klein ready. Here's his pitch. Fastball low and outside. So 2 balls and no strikes. Klein stretches, delivers, fastball off the plate. So he's in a hole, 3 balls, no strikes.
So far, Klein is struggling to find the strike zone as there is, again, action in the Southern Nazarene bullpen.
3-0 delivery that caught the outside corner, 3-1. Chris Sutton on deck for SAU, then it would be back to the top of the order. Here's the pitch. It's outside. Ball four. Back-to-back walks to start the second for SAU.
That's Oliver Wilson, left-hander, warming up at the bullpen for Southern Nazarene.
Chris Sutton at the plate for SAU. 244 hitter on the season. No home runs. 12 runs batted in. Catcher out to visit with his pitcher. Maybe buy a little time for the young man in the bullpen. I don't know.
Yeah, Entwistle, I think, is going to, well, no. Didn't make the umpire come break that visit up.
Oh, this ain't right. Sutton steps in. Here's the first pitch to him. Shows bunt, and he took it outside for ball one.
Yeah, they're going to Southern Nazarene play in at the corners after Sutton showed bunt.
Klein set from the stretch. The pitch in the dirt. And first baseman charging. Well, apparently both games did go 9-1 today for Washita over East Central. Pulled the bat back, showed bunt again, took a strike. I kept looking at it, and I said, man, they still hadn't started that third game. Well, it ended up the same as the first game today. They were both 9-1. 13-0 yesterday, so Washita swept East Central in Arkadelphia. 2-1 delivery. Runner goes from second, and that pitch is lined down the left field line, but it goes foul into the Southern Naz bullpen.
Oh, man, Sutton ripped that one just a little bit out in front, but that one definitely found the barrel with the runners in motion.
Yeah, both runners were off and running there. First and second, nobody out. Chris Sutton at the plate. It's a 2-ball, 2-strike count. Klein's pitch, breaking pitch, chopped to the third base side. Coming in, third baseman. Only play will be to first base. That will advance the runners, though. Sutton is thrown out, 5-3 on the putout.
Yeah, productive out, though. Moving us over, another station.
And top of the order now for SAU. Mikey McGinnis got nicked on the first pitch to him from the starter, Tyler Reed. in his first at bat in the bottom of the first. Took first base. Didn't appear to need a Band-Aid or anything. There's the pitch. It's down in the dirt. Good block by their catcher, Entwistle. So Wichita swept East Central. Some of the other series got it in on Friday, Saturday, mostly the ones that played in Oklahoma. There's an off-speed pitch out in front. McGinnis swings and misses. I mentioned earlier, Arkansas Monticello and Oklahoma Baptist split today. 6-5 Monticello and 4-3 Oklahoma Baptist. 1-1 delivery. It's low, two balls and a strike.
Who'd Henderson play this weekend?
Henderson took two out of three from southeastern Oklahoma State. They split yesterday. Henderson won Friday. Pitch in the dirt and outside. It's 3-1. Harding swept southwestern Oklahoma State. They're all three pretty close games.
Yeah.
And Tech and Northwestern took two out of three at home against Arkansas Tech. 3-1 pitch is foul back. Count full now. Three balls, two strikes. Is that everybody? I think that's everybody. Yep, that's all the series.
Sounds good to me.
Should have been six series being played. And again, this series, first the pitch.
Good
low
take.
And outside, ball four. Mikey McGinnis draws the walk, and the bases are loaded with one out.
Yeah, that pitch started out in the zone, and then slider breaking pitch moved farther away and off the plate. Good take there by McGinnis.
Grant Rosema to the plate for SAU.
I think we may have hadn't been a call yet, but we may have a pitching change.
Not yep. sure if
they're going to make the call.
They are. Okay, so we'll have a new pitcher coming on for Oklahoma Baptist. That's going to end the day of Lincoln Klein. Muleriders with bases loaded, one man out here in the bottom of the second inning as the new pitcher comes on. Tell you about him right after this. This is Muleriders Baseball.
At Elginning's Law, we understand that your legacy isn't just about assets. It's about family, future, and impact. Specializing in estate planning, elder law, and disability, we bring big firm expertise to our local community. Whether you're looking to protect your hard-earned wealth, navigate the complexities of elder care, or secure disability rights, we're here for you. Dial 501-501-WILL or visit elginningslaw.com. Now with offices in Magnolia and Little Rock, Elginning's Law, a good steward firm.
The Magnolia Regional Medical Center General Surgery Clinic at 1005 North Jackson in Magnolia is excited to introduce to Magnolia Dr. Jose Zamora, General Surgeon. Dr. Zamora brings more than 30 years of surgery experience to Southwest Arkansas and looks forward to serving our community. Dr. Zamora performs most types of general surgery procedures and takes direct appointments or referrals from your primary care provider. Call the MRMC General Surgery Clinic today to schedule your appointment, 870-235-3600.
Oliver Wilson, the new pitcher for the Crimson Storm. He has a 1-0 record, a 15.15 ERA. This will be his eighth appearance. He has three starts on the year. He has pitched 13 and two-thirds innings. Given up 32 hits, 30 runs, 23 of those have been earned. He's walked 8, struck out 6, opponent's batting 451 against Oliver Wilson. He is a left-hander. So it'll be the first left-hander we see from the Crimson Storm today. We're in the bottom of the second inning. SAU with bases loaded and just one man out thus far in this inning.
Yeah, big opportunity here. The catcher, Rosema, will now turn around and hit from the right side against the left-handed reliever.
The catcher, number 19, Grant Rosema.
He steps in, the Crimson Storm, hoping for a double play ball. First pitch from Wilson. Check swing. Umpire says he went around at a breaking pitch. 4-1. Rosema flew out to left in the first inning. And the 0-1 delivery. That's hit a mile high out to left, going back. Orman at the wall and leaps over the wall. It hits the sign above the wall. It's a grand slam home run for Grant Rosema.
Yeah, it took a while. They did finally call it a home run, so a grand slam as that hit the yellow on top of the fence in left field as the wind was trying to blow it back into play. Instead, Rosema, grand slam. And
did it must have hit up off the top, because if it, I think if it hits on the front face of it, it's got to be over that, right?
So, yeah, I think it actually hit the top and then may have hit one of the advertising signs
behind it. Bounced around, I think, around there a little bit, so, and then came back out on the field. So, grand slam home run for Grant Rosema, and the Mule Riders up 5-1 now. Brandon Nichols steps in. Pitch misses outside, ball one.
There's a big lick.
Well, if you're Oliver Wilson, you better be careful with Brandon Nichol. They'll go back to back. No, he won't. Hits this one on a line out into left field through the hole on the left side. A single for Brandon Nichol.
Yeah, your favorite staff, the exit velocity, don't know what it was, but it was high. That one was crushed into left field by Nichol.
Yeah, I don't need all those numbers. Hit it hard and get it high enough, and it'll go over the wall. That's all we need. Brandon Nichol on at first now. Will Richardson at the plate for the Mule Riders. He drove in a run in the first inning, swings and fouls it off his foot.
Yeah.
He's going to walk that one off a little bit.
Yeah, big Will's going to need a second or two to try to walk that one out.
Even a big, strong young man like him might call for his mama after that one. Mama, please. Rub it, please.
After seeing those last two swings from Rosema and Nichol, Richardson was coming in with the intent of doing some damage.
He's back in the box. Here's the pitch to him. He took it. Ooh, that looked outside. That's... Umpire says strike.
Yeah, Richardson, he couldn't have done anything with that.
No, he couldn't have reached it.
No.
That came around the plate. So no ball, two strike count to Will Richardson. Wilson, long look at first with Nichol over there. Now the pitch, and it's in the dirt. So one ball, two strike count. Chris Lyles on deck for SAU. Richardson has his average up to 410 after that RBI single in the first. He's the team leader in the average department. 1-2 pitch. That's hit high in the air to center field. Martinez backing up. Has room, though. Didn't get enough air under that one, and it's caught out in right center by Martinez. Got to be careful out there, though. There's a mud hole that you can see from here, just a little bit farther in the gap from where he caught that one.
Yeah, the good news is with the wind, hopefully it dries out a little more before tomorrow, and then again, SAU will be on the road for the midweek game and next weekend, and maybe let the outfield kind of heal itself of any issues.
Chris Lyles at the plate. First pitch, fastball, missed outside for ball one. A little later, our Magnolia Regional Medical Center mid-game summary coming your way. Don't have to leave Magnolia to receive high-level surgical care. Staff at the MRMC Surgical Clinic provide both inpatient and outpatient surgical services right here at home. Breaking ball misses. Call the MRMC Surgical Clinic at 235-3600. And welcome the new general surgeon, Dr. Jose Zamora. 2-0 pitch to Lyles. That's hit high in the air to center field. Too much air under that one, and Martinez is under it, and he makes the catch. So back-to-back fly ball outs to center, and that does it for the Mule Riders in the second. But not before the big blow from Grant Rosema, the grand slam. The Mule Riders with four runs in the inning on two base hits in the inning, and there was one man left on. Through two, 5-1 SAU. This is Mule Rider Baseball.
I'm Faith Armstrong. If you worry about your safety or your loved ones, Columbia County Ambulance Service would like you to know about CareLink. CareLink provides an instant link to emergency response every minute, every day. The standard version provides protection surrounding the home, and a mobile unit offers protection anywhere. The area covered includes Columbia, Hempstead, Nevada, Ouachita, Lafayette Counties, and Claiborne Parish. Call Columbia County Ambulance today to schedule your installation.
That's the sizzle of McDonald's new, hotter and juicier 100% fresh beef quarter pounder burger. Sounds good, right? Hold up. You can't hear that mouth-watering sound or taste that beefy, melty, cheesy deliciousness until you order yours, because that's when they cook it. So if you want to hear this, followed by this, hit this, and turn into McDonald's now. McDonald's new, hotter and juicier quarter pounder burgers. So good, they'll leave you speechless.
Hotter and juicier compared to prior quarter pound beef patty. Available at most restaurants in contiguous U.S. Not available in Alaska, Hawaii, and U.S. territories.
Go ahead. I didn't know if you were handing it to me or not. Okay. It would be the nine.
Here it is. Ryan Phillips.
9-1 and two hitters due up for Southern Nazarene. Top of the third inning. SAU with a 5-1 lead. It'll be Max Diaz and then Kobe Entwistle and Dax Edmonds due up for Southern Nazarene. Jeremy Adorno back to work on the mound for SAU.
Adorno's
pitch, fastball. That one hit hard down the left field line, but foul. Diaz got around on that one a hair quick.
Yeah, he hit it hard, didn't he?
Adorno already has got four strikeouts in two innings. The 0-1 pitch, that one a slider that stays inside on the right-handed hitting right fielder. Count evens at one ball, one strike. Not much wind at the moment. Diaz does have a couple of home runs. That one he pokes over towards first base, and Richardson's going to glove that in the infield for out number one.
Well, after just smoking one foul to the left side, I don't know if it came off the end of the bat or the handle or what, but it just a little pop up to the first baseman, and there's one out.
Yeah, I think you're right. I think that slider worked in on his hands, and nothing much he could do except flare it over to first base. It's back to the leadoff spot. Entwistle at the plate. There's a good curveball for a called strike one. Entwistle struck out looking back in the first inning. There's a fastball, swing and a miss, and Adorno is ahead in the count. No balls, two strikes. Adorno working quickly, slider, and that one fouled back into the mitt of the catcher Rosebuff for another strikeout. That is the fifth on the evening for Jeremy Adorno. Bring up Dax Edmonds, the second baseman, also struck out looking in the first inning. Edmonds, again, a 324 hitter, does have one home run. Adorno's pitch high and tight, and Edmonds just barely able to get out of the way of that fastball.
That one made me flinch.
It was a good one. Slider away. Count goes to two balls, no strikes. Jacob Martinez on deck if Edmonds keeps this inning alive. There's a fastball fouled back and out of play. Adorno looking very sharp tonight and working quickly. The 2-1. Fastball, that one fouled back and out of play, and from an 0-2 count to a 2-2 count. See if Adorno can record his sixth strikeout here. There's a slider, breaks back in. Catches the inside corner for a called strike three. Strikeout number six for Jeremy Adorno. Three up, three down goes Southern Nazarene in the top of the third. As we head to the bottom half of the third, SAU leading Southern Nazarene 5-1. You're listening to Mule Rider Baseball.
Tri-County Oil is a proud sponsor of SAU Mule Rider Sports. Tri-County is your number one source for a complete line of Exxon Mobil oils, K1 kerosene, mineral spirits, antifreeze, no-tax farm diesel, tax-paid road diesel, and 91-octane non-ethanol gasoline, plus gear oil, grease, motor and hydraulic oil, transmission fluids, and more. Tri-County Oil on North Vine in Magnolia. Open Monday through Friday, 7 to 5. Why would you go anywhere else for oil or gas? We appreciate your business at Tri-County Oil.
As an investor, time can be your greatest ally. When you invest for the long term, you can achieve impressive cumulative growth, though there are no guarantees. Each year, check progress towards your goals. If you're falling behind, adjust your investment mix or the goals themselves. For longer-term goals, consider a number of growth-oriented investments. But for shorter-term goals, you may want fewer fluctuations in value. Also, your risk tolerance may change over time. Talk to an Edward Jones financial advisor, Steve Hardy, Mark Woods, Patrick Dodd, or Laura Kroll. Edward Jones, member SIPC.
Well, Trey Shoup will be at the plate for SAU. He was the only Mule Rider not to bat in the four-run bottom of the second inning. Oliver Wilson, his first pitch is outside for ball one. It'll be Shoup, Clairhout, and Woolbright. 6-7 and 8 hitters due up for SAU. Again, SAU a 5-1 lead. Next pitch outside, and count goes to 2-0. The big blow in this game so far, the Grant Rosema Grand Slam. A pitch, that one fouled over towards the Southern Nazarene dugout.
Every game with Spotlight of Mule Rider. Join us later for our Bodcall Bank Mule Riders Spotlight. Three locations to serve you, Magnolia, Stamps, and Texarkana.
2-1. That one hit well out towards left. That one is going, and gone over the left field wall on the concession stand of Rip Powell Field. And SAU has their second home run of the evening. A solo shot to start the bottom of the third inning. From Trey Shoup.
It wasn't just a little bit gone.
It was gone.
Man, he crushed it.
That was a shot. And again, not much wind at the moment, but again, would not have mattered. That one was stung off the bat of Trey Shoup. And SAU now with a 6-1 lead as Carter Clairhout comes to the plate. His first pitch. Here's an off-speed. Called strike one. Clairhout walked and scored on the Rosema Grand Slam back in the second inning. Wilson's pitched that one outside. Count evens at 1-1. Clairhout, a 302 average, a couple of home runs, 21 runs batted in. Wilson's next pitch also outside.
As usual, if baseball's here, softball's there, or vice versa, usually against the same team. Not always, but most of the time. That was the case this weekend.
Pitch off speed, and there's a called strike, too, as that one drops in.
So the softball was at Southern Nazarene. They were able to play Friday and Saturday. They didn't get the rain out there that we got here. But tough weekend for the Lady Mule Riders as they lost all three.
Pitch off speed. That one hit hard between the first and second baseman. And threw into right field for a single.
Didn't get bad pitching, but man, they just lost 3-2. Well, 3-2, 9-0, and 1-0 to Southern Nazarene. One game played Friday, and the other two on Saturday. Just not much run production. Only two runs for the weekend.
We'll get back to the friendly confines next week, and hopefully can turn that around. Jade Woolbright to the plate for SAU. First pitch, a called strike, and it popped out of the mid of the catcher Entwistle.
So it's got a midweek doubleheader at Delta State on Tuesday, starting at 3 o'clock. And then they're at home against Oklahoma Baptist next weekend while the baseball goes on the road there.
One off speed, that one dribbled in front of home plate. The pitcher Wilson comes up, grabs, and throws to first and just barely got Woolbright out. Kind of a swinging bunt there, and Woolbright almost beat that out.
That was close. That ball was rolling very slowly out toward the mound. And, that pitcher, left-handed pitcher, had to spin all the way around to throw it to first. You're right, it was close. Yeah, almost beat it out.
Clairhout does advance to second base, and your rider second baseman Chris Sutton comes to the plate. First pitch to Chris Sutton, low for ball one. Catcher able to keep it in front. Clairhout has to stay at second base. Sutton grounded to short in his first at bat. Here's an off-speed inside, actually, to third. Count is 2-0. Mikey McGinnis, the Mule Rider leadoff man, is on deck. Wilson's pitch. That one hit high into left field, and Sutton got under it just enough to keep it in the park. And left fielder Orman able to make the catch for out number two, just short of the warning track.
We need a few less of these really high fly balls. We don't need to be seeding the clouds.
Well, there's been. Yeah, it's true. SAU's had some good swings, but they've got under a couple.
Yeah. Yeah, we don't need any more rain.
Mikey McGinnis has reached base twice, hit by a pitch and a walk, come around to score both times. He's out in front of that off-speed pitch for strike one.
We should be good till Thursday. There's another chance of rain coming in.
Let things dry out. 0-1. That one hit pretty well into the gap at left center. Martinez going back at the track. It goes off the wall. Clairhout's going to come around and score from second. And Mikey McGinnis racing around and has a two-out RBI triple for Mikey McGinnis. And SAU now leads 7-1.
He never slowed down one iota off the bat. He had his sights set on third base.
Yeah, just missed a home run there. Just to the right of the 375 sign in left center field. And again, that hit three quarters up the wall. Again, Claire Hout comes in to score.
So, yeah, that is an RBI. So, two runs in the inning thus far.
Martinez went into the wall pretty hard. They're going to give him a second just to make sure he's all right. Looks like he has collected his headgear and glove and anything else that may have flown off and is stretching out a little bit.
He's kind of looking like me out there.
Yeah.
Although if I'd hit that wall like that, they'd have been dialing 911.
Give Martinez credit. He was all out trying to get there, and he hit the wall going as fast as he could run. But, again, he appears to be okay. We are going to have a mound visit. Got a man loose in the bullpen, so we're going to have the fourth Southern Nazarene pitcher come in. We'll give you his numbers after this. You're listening to Mule Rider Baseball.
Hey, guys, Lucas Cheatham here. Kick off the new year with the new you. My mom, Christy, and her team at Health Quest Therapy want to help you feel your best while knocking down those new year resolutions. Health Quest Therapy offers one-on-one care, dry needling, speech therapy, LSVT Big, physical therapy, and more. Stop by 1515 East Main Street or visit healthquesttherapy.net. New year means it's time for a new you. Stop by HealthQuest Therapy today.
Southern Medical Group welcomes the newest member to their expert team, nurse practitioner Haley Quintana. Haley sees all patients, no matter the age, during the hours of 8 a.m. until 5 p.m. Monday through Friday. Most insurances are accepted. Southern Medical Group has you covered no matter the health issue, from allergies and colds to DOTs and screenings. Stop by 211 East Stadium Street in Magnolia or call 870-234-5995. Southern Medical Group, our family, taking care of yours.
Know what's nice? You could drive to Whataburger right now if you wanted to. Yeah, you could hang a Louie, talk to Reggie at the counter, and get a freshly made 100% beef double meat Whataburger with melted cheese and fresh cut veggies on a 5-inch bun. It's just the delicious freedom you have living in the land where there's Whataburger. Of course, some people aren't in that land. Wonder what they're doing right now. Probably thinking about a road trip. Whataburger. Just like you like it.
Well, Southern Nazarene back to the bullpen. This is the fourth pitcher they've had this evening. Logan Isbell comes in. Isbell, a right-handed reliever, a 9.0 ERA. 0-1 record. This would be his fifth appearance. Six innings pitched. Giving up six earned runs, he faces Rosma, off-speed pitch, low for ball one. Muleriders have pushed two more through in the bottom of the third inning to take a 7-1 lead. Mikey McGinnis on third base, Roseman at the plate with two out. Isbell's next pitch is inside. Opponents are hitting 400 against Isbell. Sophomore out of Broken Bow, Oklahoma. Pitch fastball low, and the count quickly goes to three balls, no strikes. Brandon Nickel is waiting on deck for SAU. Isbell working quickly. That ball hit out towards right. Hit pretty well. Right fielder going back. He's at the warning track, looks up, and it's gone. Roseba has his second home run of the evening, a grand slam, and now a two-run home run, and SAU takes a 9-1 lead.
Wow. Vicky's seeing the ball pretty well today.
Well, I think we've got a leader in the clubhouse as far as player of the game so far.
Yeah.
Yeah, that was a bomb, too. The right fielder went back, Diaz, and even with the wind blowing in at a pretty good clip, Roseba able to get enough of that one to lift it out of the ballpark. Brandon Nickel to the plate. First pitch he sees is a called strike. Nickel 1-for-2. Pitch, that one outside. Count evens at one ball, one strike. SAU with three home runs and what are not ideal conditions for the long ball tonight. 1-1 off-speed pitch low.
Two home runs, six runs batted in.
For Roseba? Yeah.
Yeah,
he's got the other
in
one.
In three at bats.
Yeah, Shoup has the other long ball. That one bounces in, and now a hitter's count. Three balls, one strike. Will Richardson on deck for SAU. 3-1 pitch, low and away for ball four. So Nichols going to trot over to first base with a two-out walk. And Will Richardson will come to the plate for Southern Arkansas.
First baseman number four, Will Richardson.
Richardson 1-for-2. He had an RBI single back in the first inning. Isbell look over his shoulder at first. Comes home. That one hit hard, but actually bounces out of the Southern Nazarene dugout.
I'm going to say, did it get in?
I couldn't tell.
That was hit hard.
Appears everyone is okay.
Except for that guy with the baseball imprint on his shin.
Next pitch, low and away. Count evens, one ball, one strike. SAU with one run in the first, four in the second, and four more so far here in the bottom of the third inning. Isbell's pitch again outside, 2-1. Last couple of hitters, Isbell got a first pitch strike, but then has struggled finding the strike zone thereafter. Someone else starting to stretch over in the Southern Nazarene bullpen. That would lift it out towards right field, but that's not going to carry far enough. Diaz, though, racing over to the line, and it hit his glove. It's a fair ball. He was not able to hang on to it. Nickel going to come all the way around from first base and score. Richardson with an RBI triple. Another big two-out hit for Richardson. As that was hit down the right field line, Diaz was all out, made a diving attempt, and just went off the edge of his glove in fair territory, just short of the right field foul line.
And the umpire behind first base looking right down the line, so he had a good look at it, whether when it hit his glove it was fair or foul.
Yeah,
it was really close. Yeah.
Yeah, definitely in fair territory. Chris Lyles comes to the plate. Fastball, that one lifted out towards right center. Diaz racing back. Looks like he's going to get underneath it and does. One step onto the warning track to record the third out of the inning. But not before SAU strikes for five runs off of, it's going to take me a minute to count these, one, two, three, four, five hits for SAU. There were no errors and one left on base. As we head to the top of the fourth inning, SAU leading Southern Nazarene 10-1. You're listening to Mule Rider Baseball.
Get up after a great night's sleep. Hit the fitness machines, including the Peloton bike. Then enjoy a hot breakfast prepared by someone else.
Log on to the Wi-Fi and get to work. Sound like your house? I'm talking about the Hampton Inn by Hilton in Magnolia. If you live in Magnolia, you probably don't need a room with all these benefits. So tell your family and friends when they visit about the Hampton by Hilton, where they will earn Hilton Honor Points. And nothing says you can't treat yourself to a night at the Hampton.
24 hours a day, 7 days a week, the experienced team at Southern Caregivers provides expert care to you and your loved ones. Southern Caregivers also provides needed support for seniors, allowing them to remain in the comfort of their own home and maintain their independence. A nurturing and caring companions can be matched to meet emotional, spiritual, and physical needs of the individuals they care for. Call 501-463-9990 today and speak with one of our professionals, or visit SouthernCaregiversAR.com.
Back at Good Heart Field, top of the fourth inning, SAU with a 10-1 lead over Southern Nazarene. Jeremy Adorno will face the heart of the order, the 3, 4, and 5 hitters. Here's a fastball fouled back to the screen for strike one. Jeremy Adorno has had a good outing so far, 6 strikeouts through 3 innings, giving up 1 run and 2 hits. Fastball, that one hit out towards right field. McGinnis going back to the warning track and does not make the catch. That one over his head and short hops the wall. There is a leadoff double for Jacob Martinez. McGinnis was giving it a run. He goes into the wall, but see if he's okay. Lyles, your right or center fielder, called time and is going to go check on him. Make sure McGinnis is okay. It looked like McGinnis had a beat on him. That ball just kept carrying and carrying and then took him into the wall out in right field. So there again is a leadoff double. That's going to bring up the number 4 hitter, Trey Orman. Orman singled and scored the only Southern Nazarene run back in the second inning. Dorno's pitch, that was a slider that jammed the hitter as he hits it off the fist and dribbles it towards the SAU dugout. Orman coming into today's action, a 349 hitter. Got some power with 6 home runs. Fastball swinging a miss. Adorno ahead in the count. No balls, 2 strikes. Coach Pettigrew calls time. Adorno was kind of stretching, hoping he didn't pull something in his midsection. I think Coach Pettigrew saw that as well, and he's not often you see a mound visit with an 0-2 count, so that's got to be what Coach Pettigrew was checking on there. It's a very quick conversation, so whatever Adorno said must have satisfied the SAU skipper. Adorno Cubs set with the 0-2 count. Couple looks over at the runner at second, comes home. Fastball swinging a miss, and there is strikeout number 7. So not showing any issues there with that strikeout. Blank Brinkmeyer, Southern Nazarene third baseman, will step in. Brinkmeyer flew out to center field, his only at bat. Adorno's pitch, curveball stays up just a little bit for ball one.
Sure, not much. I thought, you know, 1 minute you think, okay, he's going to call anything that's close.
Yeah.
But then he.
I think that one was a bit high. It was late breaking. Fastball, good one. There's a called strike over the outside corner.
Monty Harrington here, Market President at Farmers Bank and Trust. I've got exciting news for Columbia County. We've opened a new full-service branch at our.
I think the count is. Is it 1-2? That's what they have on the scoreboard. I was thinking it was the other way around, but I'm going to trust our guys next door.
We'll see.
That one fouled back, and boy, very late swing. Brinkmeyer able to just get a piece of it and stay alive in the at-bat.
That popcorn downstairs really smells good. I just want you to...
I keep waiting on you to make a run down there. And you need to compliment them on how great the popcorn is.
That's what I'm doing right now. It does smell good.
1-2 again. That one hit towards third. Woolbright plays it on a high hop. Zooms it across to first base. Good reach by Richardson. And here's the second out of the inning. Give Woolbright some credit there. That one took a weird hop and came up really high on him off the turf. But
yeah, with the turf infield, you don't normally get those. I wonder if it hit that. There's a little seam, I guess, maybe between the green and the brown. If it hit that, I don't know. But it took a funny hop on him.
Well, and who knows, too, with the moisture on the turf, what effect, if any, that has. But
it was up around the chin area.
It was. He quickly had to elevate that glove to snag it. Pitch, that one hit over towards short. Brandon Nickel ranging over towards the third base bag, throws across and gets him in time. Brandon Nickel, a strong throw over to first base after going deep in the hole between short and third. And there was,
I don't know how he right there.
He's
got the runner going from second to third right in front of him, and he's kind of running that direction. I mean, that's got to be
shielded.
A distraction.
Oh, yeah, absolutely.
But, you know, and you think, well, should I tag him or what should I do here? And you just got to go ahead and go with your gut.
Yeah, we've seen Nickel with that strong arm from third base. He gets the job done. There was one hit. No runs, one hit, no errors, one left on base. The leadoff man that doubled was stranded right there as we head to the bottom of the fourth inning. SAU leading Southern Nazarene 10-1. You're listening to Bureau Rider Baseball.
As leaders in the automotive industry, Magnolia Motor Company believes in going the extra mile for our customers. That's why we offer only the best inventory with competitive pricing designed to fit your budget and make the vehicle of your dreams become reality. And that's not all. At Magnolia Motor Company, we value your time and convenience. That's why we offer a virtual shopping experience, allowing you to explore our inventory from the comfort of your own home. We are conveniently located on the 7982 bypass in Magnolia. Call 234-4777 or visit our website at magnoliamotorcompany.com. Magnolia Motor Company, quality for first.
All right, team, huddle up. I got something faster than a fastball and slicker than a stolen base.
What's that, Coach?
It's called a Fast Pass from Rocket Fast Car Wash.
Coach, it's called a what?
A Fast Pass from Rocket Fast Car Wash.
Ah.
All right, Rocket Fast on three. 1, 2, 3.
Rocket Fast.
Rocket Fast Car Wash.
Rocket Fast.
It's a blast. And your vehicle is clean.
Rocket Fast, the fast and easy way to wash your car.
Well, Parker Presley will be the fifth Southern Nazarene pitcher. Left-handed reliever out of Ada, Oklahoma. Looks like we're going to have...
Well, now it's...
Is it a new player or are we just swapping gloves out in center field? See,
34. That's Jacob Martinez. That's the center
that's
fielder.
It. Okay, he was just. Maybe I don't know if he had a wrong hat. Anyway, we'll give you the new pitcher's numbers. Presley is 17.28 ERA.
It looks like he swapped out his hat.
I guess so.
I wonder if he had his glasses attached to the other one, and now that sun's set, he just wanted to get rid of it. I don't know.
1-0 record. This will be his sixth appearance. 8 1/3 innings pitched, giving up 13 hits, 16 earned runs. His first pitch to Shoop is high for ball one. Let's see, 9 strikeouts and 8 1/3 innings pitched. An opponent's hitting .351 against the reliever. Shoop lifts that one foul and out of play down the right side.
Get it, Fro.
Fro down there today.
I thought he was.
Fro or Vic one.
Well, you got a text from him earlier. I figured I just assumed he was out there in right field.
Yeah, he may be desperate listening to us. Who knows?
Well, he is hard up.
I know. That's kind of what I'm thinking.
By the way, I got to do my disclaimer.
Oh, speaking
before
of.
Before you get us in
since
trouble.
Since I offended all the Henderson, well, one Henderson State person. That, never mind. I probably need to be quiet.
Yeah.
That one low.
You can just shut up. You're just making it worse.
Well, I forget. Some people have feelings that are.
Shut up.
Easily. 2-1. Off-speed pitch, that one drops in. Count evens at 2-2.
Jeff Jester, would you have a talk with this guy?
Oh, Understood.
We're just a radio broadcast that they stick in over top of the live stream. We're not really.
That one chopped over towards third. Third baseman Brinkmeyer Field skips it across, and first baseman Hicks able to dig it out. One up, one down here in the SAU half of the fourth.
Ended up being pretty close over there at first base. So, yeah, we probably need to point that out from time to time. We're not associated with SAU. We're just
homers.
A local radio broadcast, and we're homers. And it's not so bad with the Oklahoma schools.
No.
But the Arkansas schools, we've known them for a long time, and SAU folks don't like any of them.
That pretty much wraps
That's
it
pretty
up.
Much it. Yeah. Especially Monticello and Henderson.
And Washington. Some people and don't. Tech.
Yeah, but I mean, those are the.
Claire
yeah.
Hout.
Well, you're right. Yeah.
Yeah, it's all of them.
Yeah.
Claire Hout down in the count. No balls, two strikes as he fouls that one back to the screen.
And they've all got good people like Henderson. As much as we hate to see them win, they got some good folks there that always take good care of me when I go visit them. They may not anymore, but they used to.
That one outside. One ball, two strikes.
I'm curious how the listener got my phone number or my email. It didn't get my phone number. It got my email address. So somebody gave that to him. I'm not sure. Not sure who. He might have figured it out.
1-2. That one low and away. Count evens at two balls, two strikes. Well, Henderson certainly.
It wouldn't be too hard to figure out. If you figure out that we're the radio broadcast, then, yeah, MagnoliaRadio.com, you can find it pretty easy.
That one outside. Count goes full. But Henderson State came on the road and able to quiet the SAU bats last weekend. Winning 2 out of 3. The full count pitch to Claire Hout. That one a called strike 3. And they're quickly 2 out here in the bottom of the fourth.
Redheads have a good good baseball program there at Henderson State. That's really over the, I don't know how many years it's been, but it's just steadily gotten better and better. And
they've made a couple of good postseason runs the last couple of seasons. That one lifted high. Is it going to get out of play? Is Woolbright? It does. It's going to get out of play. Fouls back. Strike 1.
And you have no idea how hard it was for me to say that. You do, but
Well, it's really been, kind of the Arkansas teams. UAM, obviously SAU.
Yeah, Monticello. Yeah, they've really come along.
That one hit out towards short, kind of off the fist. Shortstop ranges over, throws to first, and another good scoop as LeMay throws to Hicks across the diamond, and three up, three down go the Mule Riders in the bottom of the fourth inning. As we head into the fifth, SAU leading Southern Nazarene 10-1. You're listening to Mule Rider Baseball.
The Greenhouse Cottages of Wentworth Place have been recognized as Arkansas's top short-term rehabilitation and long-term care facility by U.S. News & World Report. At Wentworth Place, their mission is to provide the highest quality care to their residents, and they are honored to receive this prestigious award. Their cottages are homes large enough to comfortably accommodate 12 elders with private rooms, complete bath, a shared living room, open kitchen, dining area, and a spa. Located in the heart of Magnolia, it's the Greenhouse Cottages of Wentworth Place. Visit cottagesofwentworthplace.com.
Southern Medical Group welcomes the newest member to their expert team, nurse practitioner Haley Quintana. Haley sees all patients, no matter the age, during the hours of 8 a.m. until 5 p.m., Monday through Friday. Most insurances are accepted. Southern Medical Group has you covered no matter the health issue, from allergies and colds to DOTs and screenings. Stop by 211 East Stadium Street in Magnolia or call 870-234-5995. Southern Medical Group, our family, taking care of yours.
Celebrate summer with a great CD rate from People's Bank. We're offering a CD rate of 5.01% annual percentage yield for 10 months. Minimum balance is $1,000. This offer is effective and APY is accurate from June 1st, 2023 and is subject to change at any time. Come see us today at People's Bank. Substantial penalty for early withdrawal. See bank for details. Member FDIC.
About a 3 in the order, due up for Southern Nazarene here in the top of the fifth inning. First pitch from Adorno, misses low for ball one. Chase Hudson, then Tucker LeMay, and then Max Dias. Another one from Adorno on the way. Tried to hold up, went around for strike one. Time for our mid-game summary. Service of Magnolia Regional Medical Center, the Magnolia Family Medical Clinic, your full-service health care provider for all members of your family, ages birth through end of life. They accept patients by walk-in or with an appointment. Call 235-3555. The pitch missed, two balls and a strike. Pitch comes, ground ball to the right side, right to Mr. Sutton. Chris Sutton throws him out, 4-3 on the putout. Hudson retired by Sutton, and Tucker LeMay will come to the plate. For Southern Arkansas, 10 runs on 8 hits, no errors. 1 run, 3 hits, no errors for Southern Nazarene University. Some more stats as we go. Tucker LeMay steps into the box from the right side.
Ooh.
Bad hitting. That got away from Adorno. Appears to be okay.
Yeah, that was, I don't know if that hit helmet. It was definitely upper body, but yeah, it's good to see LeMay quickly jogging out towards first.
Whew. Yeah, and that'll bring Max Dias to the plate. Three hits for Southern Nazarene thus far. Martin, Orman, and Hudson, each with a hit. Orman singled to lead off the second inning, came around to score on an RBI double from Chase Hudson. A leadoff double for Martinez to start the fourth, and he never got any further. So now one out, man on first with a hit by pitch with Tucker LeMay. Southern Arkansas scored in every inning except the previous half inning when they went 1-2-3. Breaking pitch, strike called, throw to first, runners back. That was close.
That was another good swipe tag, that time by Richardson at first.
Pitch comes into Adorno. No balls, two strikes on Max Dias. Here comes the pitch on the way. Swing and a miss. Down on strikes goes Dias. There are two out with one on and top of the order now to Colby Entwistle. Over on the Southern Arkansas side, hitting-wise, Rosema with two home runs and six runs batted in. 2 for 3 on the day. Scored a couple of runs, obviously, since he hit two home runs. Also a homer today from Shoup. Breaking pitch. Good-looking slider in there for a strike. So Rosema with two hits. Richardson with a couple of hits. He's got a couple of runs batted in. He tripled. Also McGinnis with a triple today. So the bats are out for SAU. There's a high fly ball over toward right. McGinnis is there, and he makes the catch, and that retires Entwistle. And the side for Southern Nazarene in the inning. No runs, no hits, no errors, and one man left on base. We're going to keep it right here and continue with our Magnolia Regional Medical Center mid-game summary, give you the pitching numbers for Southern Arkansas. First of all, Adorno now, having completed his fifth inning of work. He's given up one run. It was earned. He has given up three hits, has eight strikeouts, just two extra base hits, two doubles that he has given up on the day. On the Southern Nazarene side, the starter was Tyler Reed, who gave up the first run. He hit the first batter, but then was able, and he came around to score, Mikey McGinnis, in that first inning, but that was all he gave up. They pulled him after one. And then Klein came on, Wilson, Isbell, and Presley. Is that still Presley? That's
Presley
out
there.
Still out on the mound for Southern Nazarene. And see if I can find the run column. This thing's pretty wide here. For the pitchers, Klein gave up three runs all earned, Wilson four runs all earned, and Isbell gave up two runs. They were earned as well. Presley so far with an inning worked, and he shut the Muleriders down 1-2-3 in the bottom of the fourth. Now he's out there in the bottom of the fifth. First man he faces, the number nine hitter, Chris Sutton. As he steps in, bats from the right side for Southern Arkansas. Sutton, then top of the order to McGinnis, and then Rosema. Pitch misses outside for ball one.
Well, Southern Nazarene, it looks like, has Levi Graham up and throwing in their bullpen.
Here's the pitch. That one didn't miss by much, but Sutton took it for ball two. Two balls, no strikes. Sutton's 0 for 2 today. Fastball outside. As we go, we're going to slip in our Mule Rider Spotlight, brought to you by Bodcaw Bank. Three locations to serve you in Magnolia, Stamps, and Texarkana. Pitch to Sutton, up and away. Walk him on four straight, ball four. So leadoff walk for Sutton. McGinnis will be the hitter. McGinnis is hit by a pitch. He has walked, and he has tripled. He has scored three runs, and he has an RBI with that triple. He's doing what a leadoff man's supposed to do. Getting on base and coming around and scoring. Throw to first. A little snap throw over there, and the runner's back in safely. But again, on our Mule Rider Spotlight, Budcall Bank, serving us in South Arkansas since 1903. Local bank, local people. Enjoy the benefits of hometown banking at Budcall Bank. The pitch. There's a strike called to Mikey McGinnis. Took it on the outer part of the plate. We're going to the men's golf team on our Spotlight. Stuart Druin, right-handed golfer from Mattoon, Illinois. And a throw to first, and the runner again is back, the son of Roy and Elizabeth Druin. I even looked on the map to see whether he might be a Cub fan or a Cardinals
fan. I was going to ask if that was in your part, like Southern Illinois or where.
Kind of in between, but closer to St. Louis. There's a one hopper to the shortstop. LeMay over to second for one. Not going to get the throw to first, but they get the lead runner. Had to wait. That was a slow line drive, and it bounced in front of the shortstop, LeMay, and he flips to second for the force play.
Yeah, that one kind of odd. I think that was off the fist. And short hopped LeMay out at short, but able to keep it in front, take care of the lead runner.
Brings Grant Rosema to the plate for SAU.
Rosema, he's had a decent day.
In addition to golf, Druin also was a wrestler for a year.
Wow, that's an odd combination.
Pitch comes, breaking pitch, misses down low for a ball. Most memorable moment in sports, making a long putt to go to state. Guess who his favorite athlete is?
Connor Harrington.
No.
Oh.
Tiger Woods. There's a high fly ball into center field. Here comes the center fielder, Martinez. I think he was fooled a little bit at first. Then he got on his horse, and he got in there and made the catch. It was high, but not very deep. And he flies out to center to Martinez. So there are two out now, and it'll bring Brandon Nickel to the plate for SAU. Why he chose SAU? Because of the golf team and the facilities. Volunteered on move-in day. He's majoring in personal finance. Throw to first, runner is back in there. What excites him most about becoming a Mule Rider? Future in golf. So again, Stuart Druin from Mattoon, Illinois, in our Bodcaw Bank Mule Rider Spotlight, serving us in South Arkansas, Bodcaw Bank, since 1903. There's a strike. I think Mr. Nickel thought that was low.
Judging from that reaction, I think you were probably correct.
No balls and a strike to Brandon Nickel. Here's the 0-1. Breaking pitch. That's in there for a strike.
That may have been a little high coming through.
Nobody has fixed our light yet.
Trust me, you don't want me working on that project.
I'm not working on it.
Something would.
I don't mess with the electrical.
No, yeah.
Here's the 0-2 pitch outside. It's one ball, two strike.
I'm every now and then competent to change a light bulb. Anything north of that, I am out.
I'm good up to about 9 volts on a battery. Any more electricity than that, I don't want to mess with it. One ball, two strikes. Presley's pitch is hit high in the air to right field. Right fielder Dias going back. Center fielder coming over too. Back just in front of the wall. He did not pull it in. He dropped it out on the warning track in right center. And McGinnis will come all the way around to score from first base. And down to second is Brandon Nickel. See how they rule that. I tell you what.
I would go hit.
It's dark enough out there. I couldn't tell whether whether it just was hit well and went up over his glove or went off his glove or what happened.
Well, Diaz was having to, I mean, he was on a full-out sprint all the way back to the wall, so he was, it's not like he was settled underneath it. He had to make a long run and met the fence about the same time the ball was coming down.
That's right. So it is ruled a hit. So it's a double for Brandon Nickel and an RBI. Opposite field there, out to right center field.
That gave it a pretty good ride again. Diaz go all the way back to the wall.
11-1 SAU here in the bottom of the fifth, and a throwback to second. The runner is back. After the game, got our Domino's postgame show coming your way. Carry out a deal for only $7.99 at Domino's. All their one-topping pizzas included on any of Domino's five crusts. Eight-piece wings or boneless chicken included, too, for just $7.99. A one pitch is down low. Also, Domino's dip and bread twist combos. Now, you don't get all that for $7.99. $7.99 each at Domino's.
That's good. A good disclaimer.
That is, yeah. Well, the people the other go said, you know what Dan Gregory
said? He said.
1-1 pitch. That's hit hard out to center field. But it's going to carry to the center fielder Martinez, and that will retire the Muleriders. In the inning, Muleriders score one run on one base hit. There were no errors, and one man left on base. Through five, Southern Arkansas leads it 11-1. This is Muleriders Baseball.
KVMZ-FM Waldo Magnolia and KELD-FM Hampton Camden El Dorado. 99.1 and 106.5. The new Max FM.
Short-term plans may change, but stay focused on three lifetime goals. Planning for retirement, preparing for the unexpected, and creating an estate plan. Get in touch with one of Magnolia's Edward Jones Financial Advisors. Edward Jones, member SIPC.
Hi, folks. Jim Golden with Jim Golden Ford Lincoln in Camden. They say no matter what you do, you need to do it better than everyone else. Well, that's our commitment to you, to sell you a new or used vehicle better than everyone else. How simple. We say what we do what we say. If you're in the market for a new or pre-owned vehicle, come see us at Jim Golden Ford Lincoln, and remember, it's worth a short drive to get a great deal at Jim Golden Ford Lincoln in Camden, where the dealer is the difference.
Jacob Pumphrey says I need to give a shout out to Mother Nature.
doing what?
Cleaning the window off the bird droppings.
The bird residue.
When we were here, it was just last week. There were some serious bird droppings on the front of this window, and there's still some imprints, but that
rain helped.
6, 7, 8 inches of rain, whatever it was, it helped. I'm in the wrong inning here. We got Dax Edmonds for Southern Nazarene leading it off. He takes the strike. Jeremy Adorno back to the mound for his sixth inning of work for SAU. Pitch misses outside. It's like a hard slider there. 1-1 the count on Dax Edmonds. He'll be followed by Martinez and then Orman. Adorno's pitch, breaking pitch up 2-1 is the count. After the game, we're going to name our People's Bank player of the game. 2-1 delivery. Swing and a miss at a fastball, 2-2 now. Before you lock in a mortgage rate online, talk to People's Bank first. People's Bank offers great rates on mortgage loans for a new home purchase and refinancing. Plus, People's Bank makes it so easy by being with you every step of the way. Swing and a miss, down on strikes goes Dax Edmonds, and that's the way the sixth inning gets underway for Southern Nazarene. Edmonds having himself a bad night so far. He's been called out on strikes twice and now swinging.
Well, Adorno.
So he's struck out. Got the hat trick.
Yeah, and Adorno struck out 9. So
Jacob Martinez at the plate. Pitches outside for ball one. Martinez doubled to lead off the fourth and was stranded. He's one for two. 1-0 pitch from Adorno. Fastball, apparently a little low. People's Bank, equal housing lender, member FDIC. I didn't get that part in there. Two balls, no strikes, but again, we'll name our People's Bank player of the game after the game tonight. Swing and a miss for strike two.
Yeah, still good velocity here in the sixth inning for Adorno. Thought Roseboe was going to be a runaway for player of the game, but Adorno's trying to get to double digits in the strikeout category.
Pitch up and away. Three balls, one strike. For some reason, I had three and two in my brain, but it's 3-1. It's 11-1 SAU. We're in the top of the sixth inning. Here's the pitch from Adorno. He showed bunt, pushes it to the left side, and he bunted it foul. So the count will go full 3-2.
Yeah, so you had the shift on. Only Woolbright's on the left side of the infield, playing kind of in a shortstop position.
Yeah, so he's back. So if he'd have laid that bunt down fair,
he's safe. Yeah.
He might have got a double at it.
Yep.
Here comes the 3-2 to Martinez. Swing and a miss, down on strikes. Goes Jake Martinez, out number two.
Yeah, there is strikeout number 10 as Adorno hits double digits.
Yeah, he is mowing them down here this evening. Jeremy had a rough outing last weekend. It's good to see that he's coming back strong here tonight. Trey, like you said, pitches high. It's ball. He set the bar so high. He's just been so amazing his first 2 years at SAU. 1-0 pitch. Fastball strike.
Yeah, it's kind of like this SAU program. You know, you've got a good program where you win. If you win two out of three in a conference series, people are like, well, why didn't you sweep?
1-1 pitch. Fastball strike. Caught the outside corner. It's ball and two strikes to Trey Orman.
That's kind of the level this Mule Rider baseball program has hit and elevated itself to.
1-2 delivery. Swing and a miss at some high heat and down on strikes. KKK for the sixth inning as Adorno still looking good through six innings. We go to the bottom of the sixth. It's 11-1 SAU. This is Mule Rider Baseball. Getting your prescriptions filled is easy at Prince Pharmacy in Magnolia. Become one of their many satisfied customers. You can refill your prescriptions with Prince Pharmacy's mobile app, also with their website, PrincePharmacyRx.com. Prince Pharmacy has a 24-hour refill line, too. 234-7292. Call before noon for same-day free delivery. They have a convenient drive-thru, too, at Prince Pharmacy in the Southern Medical Group Clinic at 211 East Stadium in Magnolia. It's mighty hard to resist an order of Domino's loaded tots. You have your choice of three different mouth-watering toppings. There's Domino's cheddar bacon loaded tots with a perfect combo of gooey cheese and crisp bacon. Or how about Domino's Philly cheesesteak loaded tots? Or last but not least, Domino's melty three cheese loaded tots covered with a blend of mozzarella, cheddar, and provolone cheese, plus Alfredo sauce. Add some loaded tots to your next Domino's order. Order online or on the Domino's app and earn Piece of the Pie rewards.
Hey, this is Abby. If you need something hauled all over the country, then call my mom at Bo Moses Trucking at 870-234-2803. They can haul just about anything, and they have CDL drivers. Look, if you're going to trust someone with your property, I would choose Bo Moses Trucking, but that's just me.
Bo Moses Trucking, 535 East Main in Magnolia. For all your long-haul needs, call Bo Moses Trucking, 870-234-2803.
Go Panthers!
New pitcher on the mound for the Crimson Storm, Levi Graham, right-hander. First man he faces, Chris Lyles. First pitch misses low and away for ball one. Graham, an 0-1 record, 10.38 ERA. This is his seventh appearance, all in relief. The pitch is fouled straight back, up and over the backstop. 8 2/3 innings pitched. He's given up 14 hits, 10 runs. They've all been earned. He walked in, struck out five. Opponents batting 400 against Levi Graham. The 1-1 delivery is a fastball. Ooh, looked a little outside. Umpire says strike. two.
Well, in the umpire's defense, he's had a pretty large strike zone for the entire game, so at least there's some consistency there.
Here's the 1-2. He knows we got an early start tomorrow, so want everybody to get a few extra winks tonight. Two balls, two strikes to Chris Lyles. I know I would appreciate those. Pitch on the way. Fastball, strike three called. Lyles is rung up. It was right down the middle of the plate. I couldn't tell up or down there, but I don't think too much to argue about there.
Yeah, I think Chris thought it was a little bit low, but again, it's been a generous strike zone for the pitchers all evening.
So Levi Graham, first man he faces, a strikeout. Now Trey Shoup to the plate. He's 1-for-3. That one being over the left field wall. A no doubt about it home run. That pitch misses for ball one. Carter Clairhout is on deck for SAU. The pitch on the way, and he took a home run cut. He missed for strike one.
He was going for his second home run on the night.
Next one comes, tried to check. It was either in the strike zone or he went around. I think it was in the strike zone, says the umpire.
Think so, too.
Shoup now with four home runs on the year. Swing and a miss. He's down on strikes. So this guy Graham coming in, striking people out. Back-to-back strikeouts. And Carter Clairhout, the designated hitter for the Mule Riders. Clairhout 1-for-2 with a walk also, and he's scored two runs tonight for SAU. Pitch to him. That's lifted in the air out to left field. Left fielder Orman doesn't have to move much. Now he lost it. He lost it in the lights, I guess, and it's going to end up being a double for Carter Clairhout.
Yeah, you could tell from the jump, Orman just could not locate the ball. He had his hands out trying to get some directions on where the ball was, but that one was skied by Clairhout, and Orman just never was able to pick it up.
Yeah, I'm going to say he had to have lost it in the lights and then just, like I said, never could find it.
Yeah.
And it dropped a good little bit from him, so Clairhout all the way down to second base. Jaden Woolbright to the plate for the Mule Riders. 0-for-2 with a walk and a run scored. Clairhout at second. Here's the pitch. He almost threw that to the backstop. Now he's got Clairhout between second and third. Throws down to second, and Clairhout just does get back in there. He saw that ball bouncing. He was ready to go to third, and he almost went too far.
He did. Entwistle did a great job of snagging that ball and not only keeping it in front, he actually backhanded it and caught it. And I was with Clairhout. I thought there was no way he was going to be able to keep that in front.
Fastball's a strike on the outside corner, 1-1 to Jaden Woolbright. Clairhout, was that back in the second when he had thoughts about stealing third base? That pitch misses. It's 2-1.
I don't remember that.
They ended up, yeah, he might seem like he
oh,
came
yeah,
off
yeah,
and
well,
they
had to
retreat.
Looked like
was
they
it a pitch that
run.
Got away? Yeah. 2-1 delivery. Fastball a little low and in. 3-1 to Jaden Woolbright. Chris Sutton is on deck for SAU. Two out, one on for the Mule Riders. It's 11-1 SAU, bottom of the sixth. Pitch on the way. Fastball and foul back. Count goes full. Three balls, two strikes. Who's going to be our People's Bank Player of the Game? Listen after the game and find out. Bank on the go with People's Bank's mobile banking app. First the pitch. Low and outside, ball four. So a two-out walk, and that puts Mule Riders at first and second with two out, and it brings Chris Sutton to the plate. With that People's Bank mobile banking app, you can check balances, deposit checks, view transactions, transfer money, pay bills, find the nearest branch, and more. Bank wherever you are with your local bank, People's Bank, member FDIC. And the pitch to Sutton is low for ball one. Nobody throwing in the Snoo bullpen.
Now, a couple people stirring, but I don't know if it may just be a couple of catchers and a coach down there. I'm not sure.
Here's the 1-0 to Sutton. That's a little up. Count goes to two balls, no strikes. Graham is the sixth pitcher of the game for the Crimson Storm.
There is a little bit of action in the SAU bullpen, although Adorno has shown no signs of needing it at this point.
2-0 pitch is fouled back. Is it going to get out of play? Catcher comes back to the backstop. Looks like it will get up and over and into the crowd. 2-1 is the count on Chris Sutton. So the Nazarenes uniforms, they're the Crimson Storm, and all their other teams, they are really
kind of a maroon.
Yeah, kind of a maroon, well, crimson, I guess.
Yeah.
Color, and these are more, these are more red.
These are more of the fire engine category.
Here's the 2-1 pitch. That's foul back off the fist, out of play.
It's going to hit us. Yep.
Right above my head. I'm glad I got a roof over my head. 2-2. Deuces wild here in the bottom of the sixth inning. Sutton's back in the box. Check of second, now the pitch, and fouled another one back. Deuces remain wild.
Sutton,
the first base coach will go out and get that one as it ricocheted off the backstop out onto the field.
Getting a lot of pitches to look at here. Let's see if he can straighten one out.
Here comes the 2-2. Swing and a miss. Down on strikes goes Sutton to retire the Mule Riders in the sixth. No runs in the inning. One base hit, no errors. 2 minutes left on. After six complete, it's 11-1 SAU. This is Mule Rider Baseball.
Greatness doesn't happen overnight. It takes time, focus, and dedication. At Shelter Insurance, we understand that because we put in the hard work and dedication for decades. And that commitment has paid off with award-winning customer service for your auto, home, and life insurance.
For a free personal protection review, contact Shelter Insurance agent Gary Donfera.
Knock your taste buds out of the park with the Corner Clubhouse, 100 South Washington on the Magnolia Square. We're talking mouth-watering steaks cut in-house, burgers, loaded nachos, salads, wraps, quesadillas, and more. Choose from an array of legendary baked potatoes like the Chicken Fajita and Chicken Bacon Ranch. Menu updates, picks, and more. Search the Corner Clubhouse on Facebook. Daily specials, a full bar, big screens for the big games, and only a short stop away. It's the Corner Clubhouse. Satisfy your cravings with a grand slam today.
Top of the seventh inning, SAU with an 11-1 lead over Southern Nazarene. Jeremy Adorno has gone the entire way for SAU. The Brinkmeyer, Hicks, and Hudson due up for the Crimson Storm. Adorno trying to end this one right here and maintain that 10-run lead. First pitch low and away for ball one. Adorno so far, 11 strikeouts. There's a slider. Back doors the outside corner.
So far, Adorno's faced 22 batters. He has induced 3 flyouts, 4 groundouts.
There's a swing to miss for strike two.
11 strikeouts. He has walked nobody. He did hit one batter. Has one wild pitch. Given up 2 doubles.
They make that 12 strikeouts as Brinkmeyer goes down swinging. That's going to be the last 4 outs recorded for SAU, all by strikeout. So Adorno does not appear to be worn out here in the seventh inning. He is still going strong.
Well, let's see if he can get a baker's dozen.
Well, Weston Hicks at the plate. Fastball, strike one. And again, velocity's about the same. He's going through here. Pretty low pitch count. Swing and a miss for strike two. And that's the thing. When Adorno's in rhythm and working quickly, he He's tough to hit, and he is locked in this evening. 0-2, that one inside almost hit the batter. Ran that one a little too far in.
Sometimes, you know, late in a game like this, you actually get a little bit more movement on your pitches because, you know, you're not quite as likely to overthrow.
That one fouled back and out of play.
I don't know if it makes any sense or not. I just made it up.
it sounded great.
Yeah, I don't really know what I'm talking about.
Well, that's us on everything. So yeah, the 1-2. That one inside. That one almost. There was a ton of late movement. It was inside, but almost came back and caught the inside corner. Count evens, 2 balls, 2 strikes.
That slider. Kind of close to hitting him, too.
Yeah, it was, but a lot of late movement on that one. 2-2, that one fouled over towards the Southern Nazarene dugout.
He does not want to give up his first walk at this point, nor hit another batter.
Well, I have not given that stat because I did not want to put the announcer's jinx on him. So if he does, that's all you, big boy. Swing and a miss for strike 3, and that is 5 consecutive strikeouts for Jeremy Adorno. And you're right, a baker's dozen, number 13.
Why stop there?
Let's go ahead and strike out the side.
I'm going to say, this is the seventh inning, by the way, and SAU has a 10-run lead, so one more out.
Could be it.
We're done.
Chase Hudson, there's a line drive and pass Sutton into right center field, so there's a 2-out single for Chase Hudson. He's now 2-for-3 on the evening.
Don't tell Pettigrew. I just...
That you jinxed us?
Jinxed us talking about the 10-run rule with 2 out.
Believe me, but note right here. That'll bring up Tucker LeMay, the shortstop. He was hit by a pitch, pretty nasty-looking pitch back in the 5th.
Magne on spring break. No games this week, by the way.
There's slider called strike 1. Let's say I've talked about it a couple times now, but the slider is looking exceptionally sharp this evening.
No conference games this week for Magnolia.
There's another one swinging a miss, and let's see if Adorno could go ahead and slam the door right here. No ball, 2-strike count, 2 outs. SAU with the 10-run lead in the top of the 7th. Adorno set at the belt, comes home, swinging a miss for strike 3 as he strikes out the side in back-to-back innings. You're up, Dan.
And that's a Muleriders winner, by golly.
There we go. SAU a strong performance this evening, an 11-1 win, and SAU back on the winning train here.
14 strikeouts for our starter.
Wow.
Who's going to be our People's Bank Player of the Game? Stick around. We've got our Domino's post-game show coming your way. Carry out a deal for only $7.99 at Domino's, including all of our one-topping pizzas on any of Domino's 5 crusts. Back to wrap it up. We'll visit with Coach Pettigrew, too. After this, this is Muleriders Baseball.
This week's At Your Service featured item is Odoban deodorizer and disinfectant. Odoban eliminates odors caused by pets, mildew, urine, smoke, and sewage. Odoban kills 99.9% of germs in 60 seconds and is effective on hard and soft surfaces. Get your hands on a bottle of Odoban today. Shop online by visiting atyourservicestore.com or go by 1506 North Vine in Magnolia. At Your Service Environmental Solutions, where they know the power of clean.
In Magnolia, you might see me at a local game, or we might cross paths at the grocery store, or the next benefit. I'm your local Farm Bureau agent, your local expert when it comes to protecting what you love and depend on. I'm Mark Trout. Call me at 234-1966 for a quick auto, home, or life insurance quote, and to learn more about how Farm Bureau insurance can save you time and money. That's Mark Trout at 234-1966.
Magnolia Travel Center is the only homegrown fuel stop in Magnolia and offers premium non-ethanol gas, great for ATVs, boats, lawnmowers, and other small engines. They also offer off-road diesel. These fueling options are offered at your convenience, night or day, 7 days a week, and are located on the last two fueling bays in the back of the store. Endless breakfast options, daily lunch specials, the Flavor Shot Fountain Center, salads, pizzas, and more. Lower prices with a local feel. It's Magnolia Travel Center. Full menus available on MagnoliaTravelCenter.com.
Welcome back on our Domino's post-game show. Again, Kerry had a deal for only $7.99 at Domino's. They've got eight-piece wings or boneless chicken, just $7.99. Domino's dip and bread twist combo, $7.99. All their one-topping pizzas, just $7.99. Carry out from Domino's on East Main and Magnolia, also at Domino's in Camden. Well, some impressive numbers tonight for a number of our hitters. And for our pitcher here this evening, Jeremy Adorno, and we'll visit with Coach Justin Pettigrew here. Are you out of breath, Coach? See, he don't pant a bit. He comes running up, runs up the stairs in here, then he goes back to close the door, and looks up wondering why the light bulb doesn't work.
Yeah, we got to turn that one in. Got to get a work order in. Physical plant. Sorry, I hadn't turned it in yet.
That's all right. We were just talking about my electrical skills and why you don't want me working on anything above a 9-volt battery is over my head. Well, I tell you what, Jeremy Adorno, I haven't obviously seen his non-conference games early on in the year, but he was sure dominant tonight.
He was. I mean, that's what we expect out of our game one guy, and he had good stuff tonight. You know, him and Grant were working really well together. Coach Anderson called an outstanding game. They got a couple of guys that can really swing it, and for him to be able to neutralize their offense, you know, especially when they, you know, punched in the second inning and got a run, he was pretty much lights out from there. I can't remember how many struck out in the first inning. Did he strike out the side in the first inning? I can't remember. But I knew.
Yes. Yeah. So 1-2-3.
I knew he was locked in, and you know, like I said, they punched, you know, answered back and got one there in the top of the second. And then really
with three
there,
innings that he struck out the side, that he had three strikeouts in the inning.
And the biggest thing for Jeremy this year, it hasn't really been the stuff. It's been the command. And, like, he located, you know, ball down and away really well tonight. He located the ball up when we were wanting the ball up in the zone. You know, you look up and 14 strikeouts and zero walks. You know, that's big time, especially I think he had six last outing, you know, six walks. So for him to go out and throw well like that, it was good to see. Able to keep the pitch count down also. You know, in a game like that, you want to make sure that you finish that thing up in seven innings and let him do his job, and he did an outstanding job in game one for us.
You had several guys that really swung the bat well, had a couple of triples in the game. Rosema ends up with two bombs for you, including a grand slam.
Yeah, hit one right, you know, right-handed and hit one left-handed, and that was something that when they made the move, Grant's been working extremely hard this week. His swing hasn't been where he wants it. And him and Coach Cables really went to work this week, and really the last couple of days have worked extremely hard. So it was good to see him again. Like I always say, you know, reap the benefits of that hard work. And so him and Coach Cables have a great relationship. Grant works like crazy, you know, on his swing and on everything like that. And so it was good to see him, you know, have a great night.
Somebody hit the microphone. You had another home run also. Trey Shoup hit a home run for you. He hit a solo blast for you. A couple of guys that tripled, and I'm sure that Will Richardson, like the stolen base last weekend, I'm sure that he'll use that for bragging rights with his dad, that triple.
Yeah, probably his dad and his brother, to be honest with you. I don't think.
Yeah.
Obviously, I didn't see his dad play, but I don't remember Jacob getting too many. Of course, be honest with you, Jacob, like, would have shut it down and coasted in second anyway, you know, and taken his double because he was, you know, he was that guy that wanted to stay
second
base.
Yeah, he was a doubles
machine. As many doubles as he can get.
Yeah.
But, yeah, like, good effort in the outfield, that guy laying out, and Will just kept running. And so I gave Brandon a hard time. The ball he hit in the gap, he probably should have on third, but it was one of those where, you know, two outs and he shut it down. He's kind of probably trying to soak in those doubles as well.
Didn't really have any mishaps that I noticed out in the outfield today.
No, we played good defense. We took care of the baseball.
I was talking more about from the rain.
Yeah,
from the wet spots.
No, I don't think so.
There's some wet spots out there.
Yeah, there are. You can say some. That may be the understatement of the year. But
well, I just saw one that I didn't see earlier down the right field line.
Yeah, stop looking.
Okay.
But, yeah, it's a little wet. Man, our two, Eric Toller and, Connor Baxter, our two graduate assistant, student assistants, man, they've worked their butt off the last couple of days pumping water, moving water and everything like that. So I'm just very happy, to have those guys and the effort they put in so we could get out here tonight and actually have a good performance and play well in front of our crowd.
Well, I'm sure I'm glad we got, because we had kind of moved things around a little bit. So fortunately the fans kept up with it and they came out here to support you tonight as well.
Yeah. It's one of those where, you just never know what kind of support you're going to get on a Sunday evening game, and then tomorrow starting at noon, hopefully we'll have a good crowd. Spring break, I don't think there's a whole lot going on in Magnolia other than that, unless you just want to go around and count the puddles. So really, hopefully we'll have a decent crowd at noon. And, I'll be honest with you, I'm sick of playing weatherman. So,
aren't we all?
Yeah. Wow. It's one of those where we moved it Sunday, Monday, and then we get rain yesterday and coming out of church this morning and it starts sprinkling on us and I'm mad. Maddox and Emma didn't understand why I was mad, and it's like, man, it's just a lot of water.
Came out of church, you can't be mad.
Yeah, I know,
Daddy.
A lot of water. So,
well, for folks that have to work tomorrow, I'm sure you'll write a permission slip, and Judge Phillips will write one too, so they can.
Oh yeah, definitely.
They can't say no to you too.
Judge Phillips's permission slip is so much better than mine, though. I think Judge just in front of it, I just think that you might as well, come and see him.
Especially when
just
you say,
come up to the press
especially
box.
Especially when you say hanging Judge Phillips.
Yeah, 100%. Yeah. You come up to the press box, get a signed permission slip. He may even take a selfie with you. Who knows?
There you go. All right. Coach, we'll see you tomorrow.
All right.
Thanks. Coach Justin Pettigrew joining us after the game on our Domino's post-game show. 11 runs on 10 hits, no errors, 7 men left on base for Southern Arkansas in this game. For Southern Nazarene, 1 run on 4 hits, no errors, and they left 4 on base. And again, I think Coach Pettigrew and I pretty much went through a lot of the hitting stars there for us with Rosema, with the 2 home runs and the 6 runs batted in, the home run for Shoup, the triple for Will Richardson. Mikey McGinnis also tripled in a run. McGinnis, the leadoff man. I don't know if this was his first game at leadoff.
I think it was. Yeah, I don't know whether he did
in that Washtenaw game if he batted leadoff or not. I wasn't able to come to the Washtenaw game on Tuesday. But good to get a turnaround from that too, because Muleriders Washtenaw, put it on SAU on Tuesday. But good to see the runners running and crossing the plate, and good to see the leadoff man, Mikey McGinnis, get on base a lot. He was on every time, hit by a pitch, he walked, he tripled, and then he reached on a fielder's choice in the 5th inning, and he scored all 4 times that he got on, and he had an RBI as well for SAU. But we're going to go with the starting pitcher as our People's Bank player of the game, and again, boy, taking nothing away from all those
from
guys
Rosema,
that really hit the ball well, especially Rosema with the grand slam and the 2-run bomb. You hate to do it, but I tell you what, Jeremy Adorno was just—he was spot on tonight.
Yeah, you talk about 7 innings, complete game, 1 run, 4 hits, and then the 14 punch outs. And Coach Pettigrew talked about it. The key with Jeremy, his stuff's electric, and the fact no walks and. It just an absolutely dominating performance by Jeremy Adorno, and that may, let's see if that's the spark that really really carries him through the season. And I talked about it before the game. His first couple of seasons, the expectations that we have for Adorno are like they're not even fair. And to ask anyone to live up to that is just is foolish, really. But let's see if that gets him on a pretty good roll, and if the control that he struggled with the last couple of games, but if he fine-tunes that, then again, his stuff is as electric as anybody in the conference.
The So we'll play at noon tomorrow. We'll go on the air at about 10 minutes in front of him. But again, Jeremy Adorno, seven innings pitch, gave up four hits, one run. It was earned. Walked nobody. He struck out 14, just hit one batter. So Jeremy Adorno, our People's Bank Player of the Game. People's Bank will donate to the SAU Athletics Fund in the name of our Player of the Game. People's Bank, the only bank dedicated exclusively to Columbia County. People's Bank, member FDIC. So we're on the air tomorrow at 10 till 12. Doubleheader tomorrow. Come on out if you can. Otherwise, you can listen to it on Max FM. Again, on the air at 10 minutes until 12 tomorrow. Until then, for Olivia back at the studio, for Ryan Phillips, I'm Dan Gregory. So long from Goodhart Field.